Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. Let me show you what we have been up to for the last couple of weeks.
So, for you guys to have a better idea of what's going on, this is Queen Bee kitchen, and we usually, the only access to the loft we have since we moved in is this latch that we operate like so, right? And then we used to have a ladder here, a loft ladder, that we used to pull down, all the way down to the floor, to access the loft area. So Mr. B has now removed the loft ladder. Okay guys, so Mr. B has been busy this morning. And this is, we are in the office. If you remember, I mentioned we need to install stairs to access the loft. So Mr. B has been busy in here today, and as you can see, is now a big hole in the ceiling to create access to the stairs, for the stairs. As you can see in there, there's a lot of wiring that will need to be redirected. But yeah, that's how it's looking at the moment. We have some support in there because Mr. B is going to start to cut this joist there for the opening of the stairs. So there is some other support at some point there, but Mr. B is just playing safe and adding that temporary support in there, and then he will do proper supporting wall in there, because if you remember, I said we're going to have that little corner there. Mr. B is going to build a cupboard for me there, so he will have to build a wall in there anyway. But for now, that's the supporting wall while Mr. B is doing the work in there. Say hello, Mr. B.
Hello.
Good man.
So Mr. B has fitted the frame that is going to encase the stairs for the upstairs. So I don't know if you can see there, but that's going to be the start of the stairs. We're going to break through that door there. You can see the marks there. We're going to break through that wall to create access from the entrance hall into the stairs, going upstairs. So at the moment, because we have been working upstairs, we just relocated this pull down loft stairs that we used to have on the other side of the house, and we put it up here. And now I'm about to show you something that you guys never seen before. Okay, we literally just doubled the size of the house. Okay, so I'm now on the top floor. That's a little ongoing project of mine. We are very lucky to get that unit from Queens B, so that's ongoing project. Now Mr. B has been busy at work here, so the stairs will be coming up here a bit further, probably where that bit of carpet is. At the moment it's a bit of a mess because it's a building site really. So we have this large big room on the end right corner. Mr. B already started to frame what is going to be a bathroom, and if I go through, so you can see I have loads of storage there, loads of storage. We have this Velux window that gave us a beautiful view to the back with this bullet park. And we have a bedroom here. I just have painted the ceiling. I will be painting the walls and the cupboard. So this is a good size double. Mr. B is trying to patch up the carpets there because that was originally the access to the loft. So eventually we'll be changing all the carpets, but for now that's not a priority. So we are just trying to make it nice and clean so that we can set up this for guests to stay. If I turn around, so this is going to be the door into the bathroom. So you can see it's a massive big space. Little jobs have been going on in the background, like all the piping for central heating, because it's the only thing we don't have here is central heating. This is another bedroom we have. This is a very good size bedroom. This is a lot of stuff still been up here since we moved, because obviously it doesn't fit downstairs in previous house. He was part of the guest room anyway, so he has been here waiting until we do our guest bedroom. Again, in there, there's pipes to install a radiator there. We have been doing little jobs at the moment that don't cost us any money. Don't know if you can see, but it's very good cupboards, but they had this very old-fashioned plastic bead exactly like this all around it. I didn't like it, so I removed the bead and now I'm left with quite a bit of damage to the cupboard door, so I'm going to have to fill them in and sand them before I can give them a coat of paint. Lots of storage, so we just have been reusing storage things we have anyway, and just creating storage. In our previous house, we used to have a walk-in wardrobe. Here we don't, so we have been struggling with storage for all of our clothes. So just creating storage up here, because once the stairs are installed, it's quite straightforward. So this we just Mr. B done this for me last weekend. It's quite long, goes all the way to the end. And it's actually used to be a curtain pole, so we are just reusing things we have and reutilize them and change their purpose really, so that it doesn't need to be thrown away and save us money have to buy really. So yes, that's what's going on at the moment in here. A lot of painting to do for me. There'll have to be some electrics have to be changed as well here. The only electric sockets we have is on this outside wall, double, and the top one there. As you can see, is a lot of little repairs I need to do before I can paint. So, I'm planning to have the guest bed against this wall, so I need at least a set of double sockets to be run onto that wall there. Like I said, a rod is going in there. So we literally doubled the size of the house. And this, guys, is what we have to work with at the moment. So I'll keep you posted.